Students, today I am going to teach you important theorem, basic proportionality theorem. This is very important in similarity. Okay. Now, what does it mean? What is the statement of this theorem? What we will know from this theorem, that you should understand very clearly. Okay. Now listen, I have drawn a triangle XYZ. Okay. So now I will take it YZ as a base, right? Now parallel to YZ, I am drawing a line AB which cuts the sides XY at A and XZ at B, right? Here very important condition is that this line is parallel to YZ. If so, that means if XYZ is a triangle and you are drawing a line which is parallel to the base YZ, then what will happen? This line will divide these two sides in proportion. Means what? XA upon AY will always be equal to XB upon BZ. This is what the theorem says, nothing else. But how to prove it? That is very important. Now we are going to prove. Okay. Now I will explain what is the statement. If a line drawn parallel to any one of the side of the triangle. So there is a triangle. I have taken one side YZ and I have drawn a parallel line parallel to this line YZ side. Then and see intersected. Remaining sides are two different points. It is intersecting the other two sides. See, this is drawn parallel to base. So, two more sides are there. So, it is intersecting the one side XY at the point A and another side at the point B. Then, the line divides the side in same proportion. The, what is the meaning of that? XA upon AY equal to XB upon BZ. So, see, in triangle XYZ, now we are going to prove. In triangle XYZ, what is given? Line AB is parallel to side YZ. I have written. Okay. Now, line AB intersects the side XY at A. I have written. And the line intersects the side XZ at B. That I have written. Now, what to prove? XA upon AY equal to XB upon BZ. That we are going to prove. Now before that, now construction you will have to do it to prove. Now you join these two lines. Similarly, you join these two lines. Okay. Now we are going to prove. Now listen. Triangle XAB and triangle BAY. Look at this. XAB, one triangle you have taken, and another triangle BAY. These two triangles. For these two angles, okay, they have the common vertex. Look at this. AXB, BAY. What is the common vertex? B. Have common vertex B. In the other class I told you, if two triangles are having the same vertex and their bases are lying on the same line, then their heights are equal. Okay. And base XA and AY lie on the same line, then what will happen? Therefore, their heights are same. See, if the heights are same, then what about their ratio of their areas? That will be proportional to the ratio of their base. Therefore, a area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle BAY is equal to XA upon AY. That is equation number 1, correct? So, see, their areas are proportional to their base, XA upon AY, because the heights are same. Now, similarly, we will take another triangle, triangle XAB and triangle ABZ. See, XAB and then ABZ. What is the common vertex here in both? See here, XAB and ABZ. XAB and ABZ. What is the common vertex here? Have common vertex A. And what about their base? You see, XB and BZ. They are on the same line. And their bases lie on the same line. Therefore, their heights are same. That is the property. Okay. So, what will happen? Therefore, area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle ABZ is equal to the ratio of their corresponding base. What is that? XB upon BZ. It is equation number 2. Right? Now, what will happen? We will see. Now, triangle BAY and triangle ABZ lie between two parallel lines. That means what? See, I told you. See, this triangle, you see, BAY and BAZ, they are lying between two parallel lines AB and C. Triangle BAY and triangle ABZ lie between two parallel lines AB and YZ. So, as I told you, what happened? Their areas will be same. Therefore, area of BAY is equal to area of triangle ABZ. Correct? So, I am going to write here. Therefore, their areas are equal. This is the property. So, therefore, area of BAY equal to area of triangle ABZ. This is equation number 3. Okay. Now, look at this. See, this you have got, this you have got. Near right, left hand side, you see area of triangle XAB. Here also XAB is there. Here what is there? BAY. Here what is there? ABZ. But BAY is equal to AB set. So, here, that means, see, listen here. Suppose if you write here ABZ, see, use 3 in equation 1, what will get? Area of triangle XAB upon area of triangle BAY equal to xA upon ay. Right? So this is equation 4. Now look at equation 2 and 4. See here, left hand sides are same. Sorry. ABZ, no? ABZ. Oh, BAY. BAY, ABZ. See here, instead of BAY, what can I write? ABZ. So this will become area of triangle XAB upon ABZ. Here also ABZ. Now you see these two. See, from 2 and 3. See, left hand sides are equal. Therefore, right hand sides are equal. Therefore, XB upon BZ equal to XA upon AY. Or we can say XA upon AY equal to XB upon BZ. This is what you call basic proportionality theorem. Understand? So what I tell you, now here you see, if you are using this triangle and this triangle, you will have the same vertex B, so their heights are same and they are lying on the same line. So the areas are proportional to their base XA upon AY. Here you have written. Similarly, you have taken this triangle and this triangle. So A will be the vertex. So their heights are same, right? Therefore, they are proportional to their side XB upon BZ. That you have written. Now, see, third one is what? These two triangles you have taken, this triangle and this triangle. Both are lying between two parallel lines. Therefore, they are equal. That means, here equal means what? Instead of BAY, I have written ABZ. So now you see, this left hand side of both the equations are same. Therefore, right hand sides are same. Therefore, the basic proportionality theorem is proved that if a line is drawn parallel to any one of the side of the triangle, then it will divide the other two sides in proportion. That is what? XA upon AY equal to XB upon BZ. Now, what is the converse of this theorem? Converse. Okay, suppose that is, if a line is drawn, if a line divides the two sides of the triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. That means if XA upon AY is equal to XB upon BZ, then line AB is parallel to side YZ. This is what you call the converse of basic proportionality theorem, right? So now, based on this, when we will solve the problems, you will understand better. Okay?